can't do it now?
What
oh, wow.
It's dangerous.
Get on the ground.
Get on the ground.
Get on the ground.
Нет, это не.
I'm so afraid of emus. Oh my god, it's the one with just one eye! Seriously, god, I'm gonna get out of my breath! But how do I get out? I can't! Okay, go! No, I can't! I'm trying to drive! Okay, stop it! Go away! Go! Get out of here! Get out of here! Come on, man!
Down Mayfield, and now he's on Briggs, and now it looks like he's turning into another driveway here. We're going to kind of maneuver around and see if we can get another shot of him, but yeah, he would definitely...
All right, so... grass.
Don't go to her level.
Go, 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 go. Oh, no. What's he got his hand in there for? Get your hand out. Oi, pal. Get your hand out. Just go a bit faster.
Oh, he's got the windscreen wiper. Oh, no.
He's got the back.
Pizza shop, yes.
Yeah, pizza shop. And says, can you make me one with everything?
What's that? What's that? Oh, yes.
Do you know what I mean? Can you make me one with everything?
Oh, theoretically possible.
Oh, I knew that wouldn't work.
He laughed more at the fact that it didn't work.
He didn't know what pizza was. It's always going to fall down there, isn't it?
You know that a joke's in trouble if you've got a translator off to the side every couple of words.
Anyway, I felt better having spoken to him. And I think everyone who talks to him does.
And
with everything, because it's a pizza, and he's the...
You should have said the lot. One with the lot.
One with the lot.
No.
Maybe it was a hamburger.
And England skipper Andrew Strauss arrived in London, proudly showing off the little urn. They'll spend 4 days at home before flying out for the World Cup. And Belinda, I just can't understand how something so small can be so impressive.
Well, Mark, you would know about that. Thank you very much. Weather's next with Jane Riley, but first, here's George Negus.
Are you her cousin, Kate Heather?
I'm her cousin.
Oh, she's gonna call you her worst cousin. She hates you.
She loves her. Don't turn that way.
In my entire life, I've never.
You're her play?
She is.
She's trying to get off that makeup.
Is that good, Laurel?
That's the first time I've seen him screw up his face.
Thank you.
Oh, okay, I'll come rescue you.
Kaboom! Kaboom!
Oh, yeah!
That's a horse. Whoa!
Oh!
That did not just happen.
Oh, boy.
Ow!
He's trying to.
Wait, Bernard!
Oh! 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 Oh!
Come here. Hi.
Oh, you bonked your
head. Oh. Keep coming.
You fell! Oh!
Oh, honey.
Oh, I'm glad we got that up.
I told you. Aww, boo boo.
Whoa!
Derek, what are you doing? Derek, give up!
He's okay.
Entirely. I'll give you one more. This one's even more fun. I studied with Sheikh Abdullah Adhami, who's a great muhaddith, mashallah, may Allah protect him. He's a Syrian scholar. I was studying this hadith with him, in which Umaymah radiallahu ta'ala anha, a woman came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she asked if she could pray in the masjid. And he said, no, you should pray in the innermost part of your home. So don't even pray in the living room, don't even pray in the bedroom, pray in the closet of the bedroom. Now some people use this hadith and quote this hadith and say women should not come to the masjid. Because the Prophet said, alayhi salatu wasalam, women should pray where? In the innermost part of their home. Okay, let's take a step back a little bit. It's easy to quote the hadith. When a woman is about to go into, hey, don't you know the hadith, it's sahih, I got the dalil right here. If you want, I can slap you with it, so you can go back home. Now listen. Listen, here's some history. Umaymah radiallahu ta'ala anha was married. And this woman was married to a husband, a sahabi, who was obsessed with her. He was obsessed with her. Actually, you have to learn the other text. This woman used to pray at home, and he used to poke her while she was praying. So she came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she said, my husband pokes me when I'm praying. So the Prophet called him. Alayhi salatu wasalam, he called him. And he said, why do you poke her when you're praying? And he said, well, this is a beautiful answer. He says, she stole my surahs. You know what happened? He used to make salah. And she used to pray next to him in jama'ah. He recited the Quran. She heard it one time, hafizat al-surah. She memorized the surah. And now she's praying on her own. He goes, hey, that was my surah, hey. But let's analyze this psychologically a little bit. He was so obsessed with this woman, even when she was paying attention to God on her own, he got jealous. And he used to poke her. So she said, I should come to the masjid. I should come to the masjid and pray. Now why does she want to come to the masjid and pray? Because she wants to get away from Pokemon. So she wants to come to the masjid and pray. Now, the husband got very upset. No, I don't want her to come to the masjid. If he's so jealous of her, that he gets jealous even when she talks to God, what do you think is going to happen if she goes to the masjid for half an hour? Where is she? She left me? She coming back? She divorced me? She filed a paper? He's going to go crazy. So the Prophet ﷺ told this woman, listen, go in the innermost house, part of your house, and pray there. Why the innermost part of your house? So he can't find you when you're praying. And if you come to the masjid and pray, it might destroy your marriage. So you need to fix your marriage situation first. So this is the advice I'm giving you. Now another group of women, also sahih hadith, another group of women come to the Prophet ﷺ and they say, Ya Rasulullah, we come to the masjid for Fajr. And when we come to the masjid for Fajr in Medina, when we come to the masjid for Fajr, we have to walk through sewage. There's a place where there's, you know, sewage, yes? We have to walk through filth. So our clothes get dirty. So how can we pray when our clothes are dirty? So now what do you expect the Prophet to say? Stay home and pray. The Prophet told them, alayhi salatu wasalam, don't worry, if your clothes get dirty, the dirt from the rest of the way will clean it up. You still come and pray at the masjid. These are women leaving at 3 a.m. and 2:30 a.m. and, you know, 4 a.m. in the morning walking to the masjid. And they're not driving, they're walking. And it's a long walk. And the Prophet said, you still come and pray in the masjid. Is it true that we read a hadith and we jump to conclusions? We think we know what it means immediately? Does it require more study? Does it require more analysis? So my advice to you is, if ulama are passing a judgment, if scholars are saying, this people are wrong, those people are wrong, those people are wrong, maybe they have a right to do it because they are scholars. You don't have a right to copy them and judge people. Let them do it, you don't become scholars. You don't become judges. Kunu du'atan la kubatan. Be da'is, be callers to Allah, don't be judges. Especially the young people here. If you don't have a sanad al-hadith, if you're not a muhaddith, if you don't have those kinds of ijazat, if you have no qualifications in these texts, then you should not be talking. One time I was sitting in a restaurant, and there were two brothers together. One brother had a long beard, one brother didn't have a beard.
Ну, скольки ваш пар?
Alfie, can I open the front door?
I didn't see one.
No.
Oh, Ryan, get him. Hurry. Oh.
Oh no, I'm scared. Waffle? You just fell on the toilet!
What are you videotaping?
Sure, because the cat almost took a bath a second ago.
The cat is fat.
And Grand Rapids celebrating their new title as Beer City USA in a very appropriate fashion later today. I'm Nicole DiDonato, live in East Town, and those details coming up.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. That's a way to start a Thursday, Nicole.
Grand Rapids beat out places like St. Louis, Chicago, even Milwaukee. So that's the latest we have here in East Town. Nicole DiDonato, Fox 17 News.
Oh my God.